okay. It's okay. Good job, girls. That's good. Thank you. Come on. Okay, come back over here. I told you she'd show. Shirley Jenkins, grandmother of the groom, is going to pray at this time. You may be seated. We are gathered here today in the presence of God and these witnesses to join Jason and Emma in marriage. Marriage was ordained of God when he said in Genesis chapter 3, "For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be united with his wife." It is my privilege to ask today, who gives this woman to be married?
Her mother and I.
Join me up here. I believe the greatest marriage counselors are probably not those that are in high-rise offices that have a PhD after their name, but rather those like some here who have been married 40, 50, or even 60 years or more. They would tell you today, Jason, and you, Emma, this: love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, and it does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude nor self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Your future happiness will be found in these things. Jason, it is your duty to love Emma as you love yourself, to provide leadership in your home, to provide and protect her. Emma, it is your duty to love Jason, to support him, be his biggest cheerleader, and do your best to make your home a healthy and happy one. Jason, do you take Emma to be your wife? To live together as friend and mate, will you love her and respect her, share in her joy and her sorrow, in triumphs as well as defeat? Will you keep her beside you as long as you both shall live?
Do.
Emma, do you take Jason to be your husband? To live together as friend and mate, will you love him and respect him, share in his joy and his sorrow, in triumphs as well as defeat? Will you keep him beside you as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Jason and Emma have written their vows and will now share them with each other before God and these witnesses.
I take you, Emma, or Emily, to be my wife, my partner in life, my one true love, and my teammate. I will love, honor, and cherish you always, as we enter upon the privileges and joys of life's most holy relationships and begin together the great adventure of building a Christian home. I will trust you and respect you, laugh with you when you're being pickled, and cry with you all the time. Loving you faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles we may face together. I will love you in sickness and as in wealth, in poverty and as in sickness as in health. Oh. Yeah, in poverty and as in wealth. In sorrow as in joy, and will be true to you by God's grace, trusting him as long as we both shall live.
So, I take you, Jason, to be my husband. In front of our friends and family, I promise to love, cherish, and be faithful to you. Through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future, I take you as my teammate from this day forward and will love you whether our life is at rest or in upheaval, in times of relaxation and stress, whether we agree or disagree, together or separated. Because of you, I dream bigger, push myself farther, laugh harder and love stronger. It is my vow to do the same for you, whether that means moving to the most desolate of places, North Dakota, agreeing to disagree on who's the real Five Crowns champ, cheering on the Pacers when they are winning and criticizing the refs when they're losing, or snapping my right hand. You're my best friend, and as God intended, we will journey through this life together as one flesh. You put that in your pocket.
What symbol of your love do you have to give to each other? The wedding ring is a circle, is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in love. It is given as a token of your love and deep desire to be forever united in your heart and soul. Jason, take your ring and place it on Emma and repeat after me. Emma, I give you this ring.
Emma, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my endless love.
As a symbol of my endless love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
And do it again. Okay. All right. Emma, take your ring and place it on Jason. And repeat after me. Jason, I give you this ring.
Jason, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my endless love.
As a symbol of my endless love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
Jason and Emma have chosen to celebrate this union with a sand ceremony. Each vase of sand represents both of your individual lives at this moment. They are filled with two distinct colors, each capable of going their separate ways. But as you are now joined in marriage, there is a merging of these two vases in one. This is what God meant when he said, "The two shall become one flesh." From now on, your thoughts will be for each other rather than your individual selves. Your joy will be doubled. Your sorrows will be halved. As you fill the center vase, you will be emptying your individual vase. As this sand can no longer be divided, neither shall your lives be divided, but united as one.
I wanted it to be pretty.
I have heard Jason and Emma pledge their love for one another and exchange their vows and rings as a symbol of that love. And so it is now my pleasure, as a minister of the gospel, to pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one tear apart. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for these two individuals that you are now bringing together to be one. And I speak blessing upon them. And Father, I pray that not just in this day, but all the days to come, Father, that Lord, your presence will be very real to them. And that, Father, you will make straight their path, Father, providing for them, God, when there is need, and comforting them, Father, when they are sad. And Lord, may their hearts be filled with your presence and your love. We pray in the strong name of Jesus. Amen. When you kiss a frog, he becomes a prince. When you kiss a tadpole, I don't know what happens, but let's find out, okay? I love you guys. Jason, it is now my privilege to tell you, you may kiss your wife. And now I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Ashmawi.